Hello and welcome to the new series of Drishti IAS. I am Pooja Dwivedi, and in this segment today we are going to discuss about climate refugees. This topic is important from the perspective of prelims and also from the perspective of GS mains paper 2 and 3. So let's begin with the first topic, why news. Now, it has been highlighted by a report which has been published by Internal Displacement Monitoring Center that more people have been displaced due to climate disasters rather than conflicts in the year 2020. That means violent conflicts or conflicts relating to persecution. So, if we talk about the different highlights, people who migrated domestically due to extreme weather events, it rose to 30.7 million. That means the increasing frequency of cyclones, droughts, floods, these are causing localized displacement. That means within one country. And a record 55 million people in total had been forced to move at the end of 2020, with the number of climate migrants. That means migrants who have faced the retaliation of the weather have increased. This has been shown to be significantly underestimated because of the COVID-19 pandemic, and there has been an underestimation in number because data was not properly collected. Contrary to fears of mass cross-border migration, that means from one country to another, many of the displacements are small-scale and localized, from suppose one village to another village or one city to another city, because of the localized effects of weather. And this cost economy is about $25 billion globally in 2020. Densely populated countries like China, India, Philippines and Bangladesh were hit by intense cyclones, monsoon rains and flood because of the increasing heat and increasing level of climate change, increasing effects of greenhouse gases on the sea level. It is increasing the sea level. It is also causing the raise in temperature in the sea level. And as we all know, as the warmer the sea becomes, there will be an increasing instances of cyclones such as Cyclone Tauktae and Cyclone Yaas. And while 1.7 million people were displaced within the US during the most active Atlantic hurricane season on record, these all-time high numbers were recorded even as the spread of COVID hampered humanitarian organizations' ability to register and assist displaced people. Moving on, as you can see with the help of this graph, China stands first when it comes to displacement internally due to extreme weather. Then comes Philippines and Bangladesh, and India stands on the fourth number. And floods are the most significant factor for displacement. About 88.9% of the displacements have been taking place due to weather-related changes. Then comes storms, earthquakes, wildfires, and so on. IDMC, let's talk about Internal Displacement Monitoring Center. IDMC has been established as a part of Norwegian Refugee Council in the year 1998. And what does IDMC do? It provides quality and reliable data on which policy could be formed by different government organizations, by the government, in order to look at what is the level of migration, how many refugees are living in conditions they are not supposed to live in, and prevent the increase in the number of refugees. That is why what IDMC does. And as you can see in here, the number of displacement taking from India, Pakistan and Afghanistan, especially the Southeast Asian region, 7 million people were living in internal displacement as of December 2020. India's data stands at harrowing 9 to 9,000. Just imagine that. Moving ahead. Now, recently, if we talk about 2018, as the Refugee Convention of 1951, it does not at all take climate refugees into cognizance. It does not recognize them as refugees. But UN Compact on Migration, it recognized climate change as a driver of migration for the first time. That means it addressed climate refugees as refugees, victims of climate change. And if we talk about Global Climate Risk Report, Global Climate Risk Report published recently of 2021, it showed that 10 most affected countries of 2019. And it shows India to be standing at the 7th number. So we have a lot of issues which are related to climate change. Refugee Convention of 1951, if we talk about, it is a United Nations multilateral treaty that defines who is a refugee and sets out the rights of individuals who are granted asylum and responsibilities of nations that grant asylum. The UN Refugee Convention of 1951 grants certain rights to people fleeing persecution because of race, religion, nationality, affiliation to a particular social group or political opinion. The convention builds on Article 14 of the 1948 Universal Declaration of Human Rights, which recognizes the rights of persons to seek asylum from persecution in other countries. Now, many of you must be thinking that why not open this convention again and negotiate about taking into cognizance the climate refugees. But this is not going to happen so easily because of the anti-immigrant sentiments that are rising all around the globe, especially in the US and other developed countries. It will become very hard for the different agencies to talk out to those developed countries in order to acknowledge climate refugees as a part of the Refugee Convention of 1951. Let's start on India's stand on the displacement and refugees. The right to fair compensation and transparency in land acquisition, rehabilitation and resettlement act of 2013, it does take into account those people who have been displaced because of developmental activities. Then comes Disaster Management Act of 2005, which prepares disaster plans, prevents or mitigates against the effects of disasters, and coordinates also manages responses. India is considered to be the largest refugee receiving country in Southeast Asia and South Asia. India is not party, keep that in mind, not party to the 1951 Refugee Convention or its 1967 protocol, and does not have a national refugee protection framework. However, it continues to grant asylum to a large number of refugees from neighboring countries and respects United Nations Human Rights Council mandate for other nationals. What are the certain challenges related to climate change? First issue is climate change. The first challenge is climate change itself, the root cause of all the chain of events. Climate change is the biggest factor that we are seeing so many refugees, so many people abandoning their home, abandoning their residence and moving on to other countries. First is climate change. Then casual approach towards treaties on climate change. There are so many treaties that are telling the countries to abide by the rules of the treaties. But the lackadaisical effort, the lethargy when it comes to the developed countries especially, they're very lethargic when it comes to providing assistance, be it financially, be it technological wise, to other countries who are in dire need of such technologies, such finances. Second problem is that it's a totally casual approach. Negligence on the severity of the displacement. Displacement which is related to persecution, which is related to violence, may be highlighted. But displacement because of climate changes are still very down the barrel, especially for the media. COVID-19 has posed another challenge because of the sheer ravaging nature of this particular pandemic. It has displaced the best of the best. Let's not talk about the most weak and vulnerable. They have been pushed back again, even after so much efforts to bring them back to the mainstream when it comes to providing them proper food, proper clothing, proper shelter. COVID-19 is, of course, a challenge which is right now on everybody's mind when it comes to migration. And the way forward. The first way forward is we need to make considerable progress on the treaties. Treaties should not just be on paper, they need to be executed. They need to have a very realistic, the countries, the governments have to have a very realistic approach when it comes to what the ground reality is and what more needs to be done when it comes to recognizing the objectives of the treaty and acknowledging them, also achieving them. And severity of the climate change, once every country recognizes that, considerable progress will be already. That will be an offshoot. The first point will be an offshoot of the second. Because severity of the climate change, when it is recognized, the second will follow. Nationalized legislation on climate refugees. Because there is a convention, refugee convention, there is a global compact on migration. But decentralized planning when it comes to each and every country, it needs to supplement the global initiative. Then only we can reach somewhere. Let's look at the question. Who are climate migrants? Discuss the causative factors that lead to huge number of climate migrants and also propose suitable policies and programs for their resettlement. So you have to answer it in 250 words. That's it for today. Tomorrow we shall meet again with another segment. Until then, stay updated and thank you so much for watching.